Do you ever have Excel data where people manually total different groups and how to handle that with either a pivot table or another function? Let's look at that right now. I am Chris Menard. Let's dive in. I have Excel data here that someone emailed me this. If you notice, everything looks great except they manually totaled up each month of the year that we have. As an example, cell E6 has got the sum of all the numbers above it. Down below in cell E14, they did a summation. And finally, for the month of March, they did this also. I get data like this all the time. Two easy ways to handle it. I'll cover pivot table and I'll cover group by. And then I'm going to do as a bonus a third way to quickly eliminate these totals, which is probably what I would do. But let's just look at leaving the data just the way it is. Example number one, we're going to use a pivot table. I'm going to just put the pivot table right here. What I want to know is for the rep, which is in column C, what is the total invoice amount? So we're going to go to insert pivot table. Let's put it on the existing sheet. I'm going to check rep. I'm going to check invoice amount. I'll zoom in just a tad so you can see that. That pivot table is technically correct because it's picking up blanks. So the pivot table is correct, but the numbers that it's generating are not, because I should not have that 638,000. So I'm just going to simply filter the pivot table, uncheck blanks, and hit OK. And that is correct. I could also use a slicer inside of a pivot table to do this, but I'm definitely filtering this pivot table. Method two is to use the group by function. I'll just keep this one here. I have covered group by in multiple videos. I'll put a link down below of all the videos. Here we go again, the reps. And what do you want to total up? The invoice amounts. And the third argument is, well, what function do you need to use? Those three arguments are required for group by. I am going to just press enter here to show you I have exactly what I had in the unfiltered pivot table. Now, to do a filter with a group by, we have these additional arguments. They're all optional. I'm not doing field headers. I'm not doing total depth. I'm not doing the sort order. Here is your filter array right here. Match up the reps, same exact range, C2 to C22. And I'm going to tell the reps that they're not equal to blank. That should take care of this, and it does. Exact same numbers I have with the pivot table above filtering. My issue with either one of these methods, even though we now have the correct information showing, is that I actually had to filter both of them. What I would probably do is I would copy this worksheet when I have it, act like I just got this, so I don't have the pivot tables and I don't have the group by. I'm looking at just this data. I've made a copy of the worksheet. I would eliminate these total rows. Power Query would easily do it, but if you don't want to get into Power Query, highlight all the invoice amounts. I'm on the Home tab in the top left corner of Excel. I'm going to use in the editing group, find and select, and I'm going to click formulas. All my formulas are selected. Control minus on the main keyboard is the same as right clicking. I want to do some deleting. I'm going to delete the entire row. Click OK, and now I have nothing but pure data. If I highlight column E, down in my status bar, we have a sum of 638,830. If I click it and paste it, you can just see it easier. That is exactly the same as this total here. So now I would either do group by or pivot table, and no filtering is required. Bonus tip, the issue with having this data, let me do it one more time, copy it, get rid of this. The big issue, if all you're doing is just looking at this data right here and you don't care about anything else, the filter with pivot table or group by is great. Issue with data like this is this. I'm looking at this data and I say, you know what? I think I want to sort by rep. Because of those blank lines when I hit sort A to Z, yet sorted the rep, all three of these answers down below are incorrect. Right here, just to prove it, they're all incorrect. So sorting is now throwing this off. I'm going to undo that. If I go to filter, control shift L, filter by rep. So now I've got a blank in here, right there. Don't want that either. Thank you for your time. My Excel training is available online for intermediate, basic, and advanced, including Teams, Copilot, and OneNote. And as always, I thank you for your support for my YouTube channel. Take care.